What's going on, all you fantastic freelancers? William here, and it's that time of the week again. It's time for another Dev Tracker update. As per the usual, we are going to be going over the top tweets of the week from Mark Darrah and a few from Ben Irving sprinkled in. And for the first time in a hot minute, we finally have 20 tweets to go over. But before we start listing them off, I wanted to say a very special thank you to Mark Darrah for answering the community's questions, both big, small, and oftentimes the ones he's already answered a dozen times, if not more. To honor everything that he's done, I had this piece of art commissioned by a freelancer that I'll link his profile to in the description. If you want a copy of the file, be sure to join our new Your Anthem Discord server and join in on our various conversations while you're there. Back to the video though. If you all have been around for a while, you know the drill, and if not, these tweets aren't listed in any special order aside from when the tweet was tweeted. Without further ado, let's get into it. Our first tweet comes from Brayden, who asks if the Scorch Colossus is a straight Colossus variant, or simply a stock javelin with pyro attachments. Mark replied that you need to think of the Colossus as a base chassis, and you build on top of that with gear. Scott tweets if there is friendly fire in Anthem, and if not, do bullets pass through allies, or do they simply block the bullets path. Mark states that there won't be any friendly fire in Anthem, which is definitely good to hear. He also mentions that he isn't sure right now, but he thinks allies will still block the bullet's path. A fan tweets if the Javelin's ultimates are changeable, or are you stuck with them for the entire game? Mark replied that there won't be any changeable ultimates at launch. Another fan tweets to Mark in regards to server locations. He asks if there will be Middle Eastern servers, to which Mark answered that he wasn't quite sure, and specific server locations haven't been set quite yet. Now, this is a monumental tweet, as it's the first one Mr. Darrah has answered from us. Big thank you once again for answering, Mark. I had tweeted Mark if the Sentinels are piloted by volunteered freelancers or someone else entirely. Mark replied that the Sentinels are piloted by Lancers. Chris Johnson tweets to Mark if leveling up or increasing gear level is going to be time-gated. In other words, is there a limited number of events that you can do that level up your gear and that you can only do them once a week? Mark answered with a resounding no. Throwaway tweets if the storm will exclusively have lightning slash electricity, or will we be able to change the element of the javelin? Mark replied that the storm's elements are based on gear. Fingers crossed for my pyro storm. Our next tweet comes from Ian, who tweets that considering you can upgrade how long it takes for your engines to overheat, could you also upgrade how fast you fly? Mark replied that it wouldn't be possible to upgrade speed, as the dev team wants squads to be able to stick together. Our next tweets come from Anthem's lead producer, Mr. Ben Irving, who states on August 8th there was going to be a few people coming in to playtest Anthem. I was thrilled to hear this, and now I'm kind of wondering what I have to do to get on that playtest list. Ben later writes a follow-up tweet in regards to the feedback of the playtest, to which he lists off the broad topics that were covered in the session, such as combat mechanics, feel, creatures, encounter density, gear, weapons, teamwork, and so on. These parameters were tested by a small group of experienced shooter players, and it sounds like the results were rather favorable. I'm thrilled to see the devs are taking such an interest in these areas before the game launches. Daniel tweets to Mark if he decided to go through the critical path with another player by joining their group, will he have to complete the same missions as the host of the group or solo? In essence, is the mission progress only for the host? Mark replied that you will also complete those missions alongside the group. Mark answers another tweet from Ian, who tweets when you enter hover mode, do you stay at the height you entered at, or is there a certain hover height? Mark replied that you stay at your current hover height. Another tweet from Your Anthem was answered by Mark. Talk about a good week. I had tweeted if there was a difference between freelancers and Lancers in Anthem, or is the term Lancer just an abbreviation for freelancers? See if you can find all the spelling errors, kids. This is why you don't tweet at 2 a.m. in the morning. Anyways, Mark replied that the term freelancer is a broader term, while freelancer is a subset. Manny tweets if you go into first person when in combat and third person when flying, or do you stay in third or first person depending on the option you choose if you can. Mark replied that you stay in third as you do in most Bioware games. Shadow tweets if freelancers retain blueprints or weapons achieved or unlocked, specifically a mechanism to prevent accidental destruction of weapons for crafting. Mark replied that blueprints are obtained separately. The Potato Man 123 tweets to Mark if you could do Stronghold solo, duo, or what have you, or is it locked to four players? Mark replied that you need four players for Strongholds. This next tweet comes from Sinister SOB, who tweets if the gear mods in the game are locked to specific loadouts when assigned, or can they be used in different loadouts? Will gear mods be usable by all javelins, or will each set have their own mod types. This one lost me a bit too, but Mark replied if he understood the question correctly, gear can be used across multiple loadouts. A fan tweets to Mark if Anthem on PC will have multi-GPUs of any kind, aka Crossfire, SLI, or DX12M GPU. Mark's reply, as usual, says it all. Jill tweets in Anthem when she creates a group of friends, will they stay linked together for future missions, even when they head back to their separate Fort Tarsus instances? Mark replied that in this scenario, they will stay linked. Scott tweets to Mark, if you play the story mode with a team, will more enemies spawn, will there be stronger hordes, or will the enemies stay the same and pretty much be easier due to there being three additional players being there to kill them? Mark replied that battling enemies will be easier with a full squad, but there will be adjustments to the enemies based on the group size. And our last tweet of the week comes from Chance, who tweets if we are able to make multiple freelancers if we wish to, aka can we make more than one profile on one copy of the game? Mark replied that it was possible. And that about does it for this week's Dev Tracker. Do you all have questions for Mark? Let me know in the comments section below and I'll be sure to tweet them his way. Also, be sure to join the official Your Anthem Discord server for the full resolution Darlossus, Daralossus, Caldera, still working on the name for the piece, and be sure to join in on the Anthem conversation. Lastly, a huge thank you to my Patreon supporters. I never had a plan to make a Patreon account until I got an email one day from William Oliver asking me to make one. An extremely special thank you to you guys for supporting my content. Anyways, freelancers, I hope you all have a phenomenal week, and I'm looking forward to seeing you all in the next video. Peace out, everyone.